Welcome back, people. In the last video, we saw how to mount our cloud drives as a local drive. This time we will see how to mount cloud drives as a persistent Windows drive. So without further ado, let's get started. Like we saw in the last video, to mount the cloud drive we got to use the mount command in the command prompt. But the biggest disadvantage in this method is that, if you close the command prompt, the drive gets unmounted. To solve this issue, we will be using a small utility called NSSM. NSSM stands for Non-Sucking Service Manager. To download it, go to your browser and search for NSSM. Go to the NSSM website and download the pre-release build if you are using Windows 7, 8 or 10. Extract the zip to your desired folder and open a command prompt in the NSSM folder. If you are using Windows 10, command prompt might be replaced with PowerShell, so to open command prompt in PowerShell window, type cmd and press enter. Now type NSSM and press enter to get the list of commands you can use. We will go with NSSM install command, which will open the GUI. Type NSSM install followed by the service name of your choice. In this example, we will use Google Drive as the name. Once you press enter, the GUI will open. Here in the path, select the location of the rclone app. I have the rclone app extracted in the C drive. Now in the arguments, we will enter the mount command that we used to mount our cloud drive. But this time we will type the command without the rclone prefix. So the command would be mount vfs-cache-mode for Google Drive followed by the drive letter to which you want to mount your cloud drive in your system. If you forgot the name of your cloud drive in the rclone, you can easily find it by opening a command prompt in rclone folder and entering the command rclone.config. Now back to the arguments. Here along with the mount command, we should be specifying the rclone.config file location, since we are installing the mount command as a system service. To find the location of the config file, open file browser, go to C drive, open users, then, open your username folder, open .config, find rclone folder. Either you can point it directly to this location in the arguments, or you can copy this config file to the rclone folder itself and point its location in the arguments tab. So now along with the mount command we will type the following. Hyphen hyphen config, then the location of the rclone config file, along with the file name enclosed in double braces. You can leave the other tabs in the GUI as it is and press install service. Once installed, for the first time alone you have to start the service manually. To do that, open start, type services. Once the window opens, scroll down to find the name of the service you have given. Remember, we gave Google Drive as the name. Right-click it and select properties, check for once if the startup type is automatic. Once confirmed, press start. And boom! Go to the file browser and you can see your cloud drive mounted as a local drive. You can close all command prompt windows and see that the cloud drive is still mounted. So that's it for now, folks. In the next rclone series, we will see how to encrypt our cloud drives to prevent the Big Brother from peeking. Until then, aloha.